What's going on, everyone? So today we're going to be drawing Boo and cutting him out. This isn't going to be an in-depth process of how to draw Boo. I'm not going to do a lot of explaining. There will be some time lapse, some normal speed stuff. Because right now it's kind of windy, kind of loud out here. So we'll just see how the video goes. So this is the image of Boo that we're going to be working with. So you may or may not be able to see what I'm drawing in a minute. I usually start really light, just like you would on paper. But I'm gonna zoom in on my reference here. So I'll start with the head. It's gonna be a pretty decent sized piece. It's not going to be his full body, it's just going to stop at his belt. And like I said, in the last video, I may have to add material for this arm and possibly this hand, maybe, maybe not. So we'll see. So I just start with the circle for the head. Most people do. Nothing spectacular here or any different. Hope you guys can hear me. All right, so head somewhat angled. So we'll just mark a little line, like so. Don't worry about being sloppy. Just get something down. Then we have the two little angular shapes that form the jaw. Okay, so just pay attention to your reference. Might be a little too angled, I don't know. We'll see. And that's okay. I mean, if you mess up while you're drawing, you have an eraser. This is just a rough outline. Alright. And you can go ahead and form the rest of the head if you want. You don't have to. I'm just kind of at the head. Usually what I do at this point, I will place where the features go, but I'm not going to be super detailed about it, just so I know the proportions of the head and where everything is connecting and sitting is correct. And you can just adjust accordingly. And with that being said, I think I'm going to stop with the explaining for now and just kick it into time lapse. I'm sorry if my head pops in and out of the way. See, now this is what I do. I'm placing the finger right next, as you can see, is where the eyebrow line. But you can see this odd little shape in here. And I try to match that shape, the size of that shape, where the head, this eyebrow, and finger, they all are forming this shape. Sorry if the camera's a little shaky. Like I said, it's a bit windy out here. All right. I mean, you can place things, whatever will help you, like this little steam pour thing. You can place that, then you can know where the thumb will kind of be. And you can see how far things should be spaced apart. So you have his shoulder right here. Okay. And his thumb. And you can go ahead and indicate his other fingers. Like I said, none of this has to be perfect. It's gonna look sloppy, but this is not the final result. I always start off super sloppy. I feel like maybe most artists do, maybe some don't, I don't know. But you just have to get something down and then adjust accordingly. Okay. And you can taper that off so it's a bit smaller. Like that. And the shoulder, you have a little bit of bicep here. Foreshortened. tapers into the thumb. Just look where your lines are. Trust your reference. Pay attention, because then there's a little lump right here. Another indication of the palm. You have your fingers, you have the palm here. His wristband, which goes underneath that. I mean, see, sloppy, but you can tell what it's going to be. All right. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna shut up now, and I'm gonna do some of this drawing off camera. And I think I'll do the head, maybe the antenna portion. And then once we get back to this arm, I'll be back speaking with you guys. Show you guys what we got so far. And I didn't cut too much out. Just placed a little antenna here. Some of the chest, some of the lat, and then the rest of the shoulder. As you can see, like I said, I'm gonna reiterate here, it's not perfect. I almost got ahead of myself, almost started drawing the other side. So now all we have to do is look at his neck and trap here. And this is how I place things. This is how I'm sure a lot of artists do things. You look at the distance between the ear, the jaw, okay? This isn't even perfect, okay? So, okay, hold on. This lighting of this pink shadow over here, this bright pink shadow is throwing me off a little bit. You have a little bit of a gap here. Okay, there's a gap. I was trying to put the trap right there, but then it closes, it makes the distance between the ear and the trap closer, and it needs to be a little further than that. So now we bring it the trap down a bit. See, it looks a little better. Nothing's gonna be perfect. I mean, you're gonna get it close. So we may have to add material, maybe not, because Boo's not a super big character. All right, so you got a little wave here, a little indent. This is just what I call things as I'm drawing them. And a little bump here for the shoulder. So yeah, we will have to add a little bit of material. This is why I didn't add it yet, because I didn't want to put a bunch of extra material here. And then not really need it, or place it too high, and then I have his head here, and I'm thinking his arm's gonna be here. Now I can just adjust accordingly. Just in case some of you were wondering why I didn't just go ahead and glue up a bigger panel to begin with, this, in my opinion, is the better way to do it. As you can see, it's still, there are things that need to be adjusted here. His chest and stuff is looking a little off, but that's okay. We just need the general shape of Boo and correct proportions. So we have another indent here, the bicep. That's why I say we're gonna need more material. As you can see, as I draw this arm, it's gonna come off and down. So for his hand and forearm, he's got really weird, oddly big hands and kind of a big forearm. Let's see. All right. So I might kick it in a time lapse here. I'm gonna adjust the camera a bit so you guys can see what I'm doing. And so I can see what I'm doing. And one other thing, you see me using a reference, guys. Most people do use reference when drawing, professional artists. Even if you're drawing something realistic, what have you, even if you were drawing an original image of Boo, Vegeta, or said character, you're going to look at images for reference, whether it's the original character or another pose or a life reference. You use reference in order to get better. How can you get better if you don't know what the subject looks like? So as I'm drawing here, I'm learning what Boo looks like. I am studying his figure. You see what I'm saying? So don't be afraid to use reference. Artists use reference. I don't know what the whole thing is about, you know, this egotistical thing that, oh, well, I drew without using reference. I mean, that's cool, but that doesn't mean you're an inferior artist if you do use reference. So keep that in mind. That was a nice little tangent. Okay, let's kick this in a timeline. All right, so for the rest of his shape, like the belt line and everything, I'm gonna do that off camera. I'm gonna like define more of these proportions so I have an accurate cut. And then once I define these proportions, I'm gonna do that off camera. Then when I come back in video, we're going to put the other portion over here for the rest of the hand and arm. So, that's what we got so far. Now we're going to, for time's sake, always for time's sake, if you add material or make a panel, that's the reason for this device here, this jig, because I don't want to have to wait on this to dry, and I should be able to cut around it for the most part. I don't know, we'll see. We'll see. Okay, so let's drill our holes. I already have my piece cut. Here's my piece. We'll go up against it like so. Should be plenty. Okay. Someone up there. You can mark them, you don't have to. I'm gonna mark where I want it though. So I'm gonna do one here, okay. And then you can do this number. These lines aren't perfect, so don't stress out about that. And then I just mark them on the back so I know where it's going. Okay. All right. So now you just make this jig flush with this board, and then you're gonna clamp it down. They do have clamps for this jig. I don't have one. They're a bit pricey. Hints as to why I don't have one. Maybe one day. But you can get by. This clamp here is like $4 to $6 versus $30 or maybe even $40. So, something to keep in mind. I think this jig itself, this is the lower end of the Craig jig. They have steps above it. This is the cheapest one you can get. So you could buy this for $20, I think. And I think it comes with the drill bit, the jig itself, and the bit that you need to attach the screws or drive in the screws. And then you could get this for like I said, $4 to $6. Versus paying, you know, $20 and then buying a clamp for $30 to $40. Now it does take a little more time. The other one you can just pop it off and pop it on with no problem. You don't have to twist it. This is a C clamp. Now we're gonna glue it up. I got this board because it's a little more flat than that one. It's got glue all over it and a little bit bumpy. You can see my Vegeta silhouette of the cutout that I did, and I painted the back of it last night. I'll show you guys that cutout in this video, actually. So, bring this up. This is a pretty good amount. As you can see, I used a good amount of glue. I'm gonna go ahead and wipe some of it. Ah, shit. I'm gonna wipe some of it off. Damn, that's a lot of glue. Okay. Now I'm just gonna try to make sure this is flat a bit. It's not gonna be perfect. Really? Come on. All right. A little bit. One more. Okay, just go ahead and take this clamp off. Might not have even have helped, but I'm gonna drive them in a bit more. Stripped out. Damn, it broke off in there. Son of a bitch. Alright, so I need another one right there. Yeah, we need another one. Okay, so I'm gonna re-drill that. I'm gonna put it there or there beside it, whatever. I didn't even expect that to happen. That's pretty crazy. So we got that all squared away. Now I just need to gonna wipe it off a little bit more. Flip it over to the same. It's not that noticeable on this one. This one actually came out pretty good, but that was why I used the clamp too, to on a flat surface, so it wouldn't be all crooked or anything like that. The boards would be very well aligned together. And when you have the dowels, you don't have that much of an issue. This is actually about as good as that one, but even with that little bit of raise there, and there's a little bit down here, you can just sand it flat. And that's what we're gonna do. Okay, before we start cutting, we need to remove any hardware screws. Once you cut it out, and if these holes remain, whatever holes remain, you can plug the screws back in there. Okay, so before we cut, or before I cut, what I like to do is clamp my piece down so it doesn't move, it's not bouncing around all over the place, because if you have this here and your jigsaw is going, it'll be doing like so, okay? We'll be right back. So just take your time when you cut. Don't feel the need. I mean, it can cut curves, but if you try to curve it too fast, it's gonna jam up on you a little bit. And it might shoot you into your piece or whatever. So just be careful and take your time. Now I'm just gonna cut that piece off. Now, just need to make sure my blade will fit in the hole, and it does. Have to be careful with this part, so go slow, because it could snap off. You have different areas that are more prone to breaking than others. And this isn't the hardest wood ever, it is. Got the image cut out, and I've already put the screw back in the pocket hole. Can't do this one because that's where the one screw snapped off, and can't do this one because, as you can see here, there's nothing to connect. So what I'm gonna do now is fill those holes, and that will be the end of this video for part two. So show you guys. We're gonna take these plugs, put some glue, pop them in, okay? And then I also have some wood filler for stuff like this, okay? We got one here and one here. And then that should be it for that one. And then the next video, I'm gonna sand, clean it all up, paint the back, paint the sides, and then we'll do the detail work and the line work, and then I may do the painting video as the last segment. So now what we're gonna do, just like with the dowels, just not as much, we're gonna take these, sand them down a little bit, because sometimes they don't fit very well in there. I mean, these are pocket hole plugs, but they still give me some trouble. Test it. Yeah, it's fine. Okay, so it's pretty tight. Let's pour some glue in there. And then see it pop out. And I'll just wipe the glue off. And these are puffed out now, but we'll sand everything flat. And you can still see a piece of that screw, but this whole area will be painted black. It'll look good. Now we're gonna take this plastic wood. The color is natural. Sorry for the lighting, it's dark outside. And then we'll just fill in those holes. Just get some on your finger. Some there. Might have to do more of this on this hole later because there's a glue coming out of that hole too. All that will solidify though. And then just one more hole on the top portion. So, you guys see that? Push it on there. And then when we come back, once all of this is dry, everything will be sanded, nice and clean. You see all these marks and glue and this high spot here. It's coming together though.